Hey friends, it's Sonia Miller with Junk Monkey Paint Company, and welcome back to my daily vlog. Today I'm going to share with you a fun project. This is what I love to do with old cabinet doors that I find when I'm out junking and picking, and I find these cabinet doors for 25 cents. Sometimes I find them for free. How about you? Have you ever repurposed a cabinet door? So I have painted tons over the years, and I turn them into chalkboards, I turn them into signs with words on, or I do like I'm about to do today, which is turn one into a beautiful mermaid sign. I ended up keeping this one for myself because sometimes you create stuff that you just cannot bear to part with. So the supplies that I'm using today is the cabinet door, whether it's painted or unpainted, doesn't mean anything. I'm using my chalky style paint that sticks to pretty much anything under the sun. I didn't have the primer, sand, or strip. And the color I'm using, by the way, is called Blue Slate. I'm using my favorite brush to give me some full coverage. All the supplies, the paint that I use, by the way, guys, if you don't know, you can find on my website at junkmonkeypaint.com. And I also have a jar of the white antiquing or highlighting glaze, however you want to think about it, to the side of me, and that's my heat gun, so I can speed up this process and we can go through it pretty quickly. So I'm distressing my paint job right now real quick and dusting it off as well because I'm preparing for the glaze at this point. So I put down the paint, let it dry, and glaze goes on top of your paint. Think about it like a donut that has glaze on top of the donut. It lays on top and it changes up your paint job. So right now it's just straight blue slate. I could seal it and maintain this color, or I could grab a little bit of my white highlighting glaze, antiquing glaze. It really gives a whitewash to your paint, which is really cool. A lime wash kind of look. You'll see what I mean in just a second. So what you do is just brush it on. I tell you guys to do it in one section at a time because what you don't want to do is have your actual glaze dry on. Sometimes people message me and they say, Sonia, do I just like brush it on and that's it? You brush it on, but the next step is having your cheesecloth next to you. Do you see right there on the side that I have it there? I'm about to make that damp with a little bit of room temperature water. And then what I can do is get ready to go ahead and wipe off my glaze. Now, the longer I let the glaze stay on here, that means that whether I'm using a dark glaze or a light glaze, the more dramatic the effect is going to be. So I put it on. Now I've got my damp cheesecloth and now I'm wiping it off. So you can see me making sure it's damp. You don't want to saturate it because what you don't want to do is really soak your paint off that you've already put on and reactivate your paint underneath. So you want to move quickly. You want to have a damp cheesecloth. The reason why I like cheesecloth is because it doesn't give any furries. It gives a really nice, you see how like the lines that it gives you, the variations, like when you're wiping it off, it just gives a really cool professional look when you're using cheesecloth, just the way that it's made. I'm turning it over and wiping in straight lines. You always want to keep turning it over because otherwise your cheesecloth will get full of the glaze, and then what, instead of wiping it off, you're just going to keep wiping it on, right? So keep changing over, moving it in your hands as you go, your cheesecloth I'm talking about here, so you can just wipe it off. And there you go. Isn't that beautiful? So I did one section at a time, and now, again, I'm drying it real quick so we can move on to the very next step. Pretty happy with that. This is just a door. Imagine if you did this to an entire buffet or a dresser. So I'm choosing to repurpose this cabinet door into a little piece of decor. You know, I'm a girl from the island. I love me my mermaid stuff and stencils. And so this is a fun little stencil I have. I'm picking up now on my shabby chip brush a little bit of the vintage white. And if you don't know, our white antiquing glaze also is made to match our vintage white chalky type paint. So that means that if I put white like I'm doing on here, it's going to really coordinate well with that white glaze. So the shabby chip brush doesn't give me full coverage like the other brush that I used originally, the Wooster shortcut brush that you saw me paint with. So it gives me a really cool distressed effect because, again, it doesn't give me full coverage. So it looks like parts of the mermaid might be missing, and I like that look. So I'm going to dry that real quick. And now that it's dried, and let me tell you, the paint does dry quickly, I can go ahead and distress a little bit more if I want to knock any paint off of the sign. I've decided to bring the white not just in the center of the door, but around the edges. And so this is where we do what I call the eyeliner effect. And we affectionately called this at our store the eyeliner effect when my employee Kate was like, so it's like when you put eyeliner on. I'm like, yes, edging eyeliner. We're putting a little bit of winged eyeliner on this piece right now to really balance it out. And I'm just kind of like stippling and dropping on a little bit more of the white paint to match up and really get a really cool overall distressed effect. So now I'm reaching for my Monkey Shine, which is our all natural oil wax finish. I pick it up on my brush, I wipe it all over the piece, it saturates it, protects it, sucks into the piece, and then we wipe it off, and guess what? She's done. And there we go. Look how pretty that is. Ooh. She is gorgeous, baby. She is gorgeous.